Education officials and other stakeholders giving mixed reactions to a proposal to open the Philippine education sector to more foreign investors. Let's get the details from RJ Cruz.
All of you.
The Department of Education follows the lead of its secretary, Vice President Sara Duterte, in rejecting charter change to relax foreign investment limits in education. During the resumption of the House deliberations on amending the Constitution, the agency told lawmakers that appending the phrase "unless otherwise provided by law" may expand the control of non-Filipinos on educational institutions.
Expanding the scope and administration over educational institutions to foreign entities may affect the programs and commitments of the department, specifically with respect to the implementation of the curriculum.
The DepEd insists only Filipinos can teach about nationalism and patriotism as mandated by the charter.
How can foreign entities who are not citizens of the Philippines and therefore may lack first-hand experience with Filipino culture and values effectively impart a sense of patriotism and nationalism to learners?
The agency also sees as a national security concern the possible removal of limits to non-Filipino students and the prohibition of the ban on schools exclusive to non-Filipinos.
This susceptibility to external and foreign influence raises concerns regarding national security, as it may expose these educational institutions to infiltration and compromise.
This group of private schools also rejected charter change because Filipino schools may not be able to compete with better funded foreign educational institutions.
We believe that the increase or full foreign ownership of our educational institution will lead to a more heightened, if not inequitable, competition. This is because foreign institutions will have more resources as opposed to our local private schools.
There's also a warning that students may not be able to afford to study in foreign schools who will set up shop in the country.
The education that they will offer will be affordable only to an extremely small number of students. As such, it is unlikely that the presence of foreign institutions in the country will revolutionize Philippine higher education.
This youth group also voiced its objections.
Primarily, it will accelerate the denationalization of education that will lead to the deprioritization or, at worst, removal of subjects such as Philippine history, culture, language, civics, and many other humanities-related subjects because they are not deemed marketable or advantageous to profit generation.
Higher learning institutions, though, are open to more foreign investments. The Commission on Higher Education believes the government should even hand out incentives.
The position of the Commission is that if indeed a law is provided, it must include also incentives for foreign nationals and foreign companies to participate in higher education institutions, so that we can benefit from their participation.
Meanwhile, a retired Supreme Court Justice doesn't believe Congress is empowered as a legislature to amend the charter.
If Resolution number 7 is approved, we would be permitting the amendment of the Constitution by ordinary legislative act. That would be a travesty of the supreme law.
Minority senators believe the Senate won't be able to muster the required number of votes to approve charter change, prompting an appeal from this House lawmaker.
I think it is now incumbent on the Senate President to show his leadership to muster enough votes so that we can get the RB86 approved in the Senate.
In a related matter, Congressman backed the objection of election lawyer Romulo Macalintal in conducting a plebiscite simultaneous with the 2025 midterm elections. Macalintal disagreed with President Ferdinand Marcos Jr.'s preference as he maintained that nothing in the Constitution allows the holding of a plebiscite with an election. RG Cruz, ABS-CBN News.
Inflation in the Philippines accelerates in February. The consumer price index came in at 3.4%. That's up from January's 2.8% reading. But it's still well within both the Philippine Central Bank's forecast and government's 2-4% target range. The main drivers of acceleration: increases in food prices and transport costs. February's uptick snapped the downtrend in Philippine inflation, which ran from October 2023 to January this year. Well, the chief of the National Food Authority and over 100 of its employees suspended amid a probe into the allegedly anomalous sale of rice buffer stocks. Johnson Manabat gives us a full story.
The Department of Agriculture suspends 113 officials and employees of the National Food Authority for 6 months for the alleged involvement in the controversial sale of rice buffer stocks. Agriculture Secretary Francisco Chu Laurel Jr. said the ombudsman found merit to preventively suspend NFA officials, including its administrator Roderico Bioco, assistant administrator for operations John Robert Hermano, and several regional managers and warehouse supervisors of the agency. Earlier, NFA assistant administrator for operations Limuel Pagayunan disclosed the alleged selling of 75,000 bags of NFA rice without undergoing proper public bidding. In his letter to the Office of the President and other officials in early February, Pagayunan alleged that Bioco issued a memoranda allowing the sale of 75,000 bags of NFA rice totaling 93.75 million pesos to certain traders. Laurel said he has been in contact with the ombudsman since the sale of rice buffer stocks was raised.
I condemn this at hindi natin paralampasin ang anumang uri ng korupsyon. Kaisa ako sa ating ombudsman sa layunin nitong alamin ang katotohanan at parusahan ang dapat parusahan.
A special panel of internal investigator has been created to determine culpability and to ensure how the agency can prevent similar incidents in the future. Bioco, according to Laurel, had already filed a leave of absence last Friday to give way for the investigation of the ombudsman.
Yung transaction na alam kong finlag ng accuser started yata from November lang 2023 until now. So, no. But then of course, the other side, the accused naman is saying na maraming nangyayari actually before that.
The suspended NFA officials can still appeal to the ombudsman. Meanwhile, the Philippine Senate will be conducting its own investigation. Senator Cynthia Villar, chairperson of the Senate Committee on Agriculture and Food, said she herself was not able to find NFA rice in the market.
Bakit mo naman ipagbibili ang NFA rice? Eh, a subsidy yun ng government for the people na kailangan ng rice, like the victim of calamities at saka yung mahihirap. The subsidy was not meant to subsidize the trader. The subsidy was meant to help the poor people and the calamity na affected na mga tao.
The agriculture chief will take over temporarily the position as the caretaker of the NFA. Johnson Manabat, ABS-CBN News.
Airport officials mulling hefty penalties against NAIA's cleaning service providers over pest sightings at Manila's main gateway. The MIAA, however, admits a holistic approach is needed to address the problem.
We will continue to monitor this regularly. Definitely, this is something that's unacceptable. We will impose more penalties, perhaps, to our service providers. We'll observe better measures so that we can really avoid similar situations. This requires a holistic approach from the service providers to our concessionaires, even to our passengers, and even us at the airport. All of us would have participation in this. And hopefully, we do everything that we can so that we can contribute to a cleaner and much better airport.
Meanwhile, a Philippine lawmaker is urging the MIAA and San Miguel Corporation, which won the bid to rehabilitate the airport, to join forces in addressing the infestation. Marissa Magsino has called for a probe into NAIA's pest problem.
Meron nga tayo ngayong issue na magkakaroon na ng modernization. Kinakailangan pa rin immediate action, ma-address pa rin ang maintenance at saka mga housekeeping deficiencies natin, itong mga problema ito. Dahil ito'y matagal ng problema. Kaya dapat itong maintenance, housekeeping na ito, ma-streamline to immigration processing na ito, itong traffic routing na ito sa airport premises na ito, kahit hindi pa natatapos o na-final yung privatization, yung itong pinag-uusapan ngayon, dapat talaga i-address na ng GM natin.
Traffic enforcers of local government units in Metro Manila will now need to seek the permission of the MMDA to be able to issue traffic violation tickets. Let's get more on the Supreme Court's ruling on this issue from our correspondent Adrian Ayalin. Adrian, go ahead.
Hi, Carmina. The Supreme Court has released its decision preventing traffic enforcers of local government units to issue traffic violation receipts unless deputized by the Metro Manila Development Authority. In the decision of the ANBANC promulgated last July 11, 2023, a permanent injunction was given to LGUs from issuing ordinance violation receipts or OVRs and confiscating licenses unless they were given authority by the MMDA. The High Court declared specific ticketing provisions in local ordinances of various Metro Manila cities and municipalities. The High Court, in effect, reversed the decision of the Court of Appeals, which earlier ruled that there is no conflict between the MMDA law and the local government code because each has their specific boundaries. In their earlier petition for review on certiorari, transport groups assailed the validity of ordinances of local government units. The respondent LGUs, for their part, argued before the court that they are vested by law the power to regulate traffic within their territorial jurisdictions. But the Supreme Court decided in the end that the common provision on ticketing system in local traffic ordinances are invalid. Carmina, it is worth emphasizing that the Supreme Court has just released its decision. But local government units should have been implementing this single ticketing system by the MMDA since, again, the decision was promulgated July last year.